I do believe I was 15 when I first started playing this beaut right here. This amazing thing. Oh, yes. I'm mostly self-taught, so when I started playing guitar, I really just read the book that came with the guitar and just learned from there. All right, so tuning isn't like an actual like a really important thing because if you don't, you will sound very bad. So basically, there's a lot of ways you can tune. There's a lot of apps that you can have on your phone to do that. You just have to search up guitar tuner and then you can go from there. Or you can do it by ear, which is harder than you think. Or you can use a piano with the keys. You can do it that way as well. There's many ways you can do it. So an example of like an app that I use for tuning my guitar is PitchLab Pro. Basically, it's a really good, it's the best one that I found, and it keeps me in tune all the time, so it's good. How do I stay on beat? There's a lot of ways you can stay on beat. If you have a lot of rhythm, you can just kind of do it by yourself. But to stay on beat, there's a lot of counting. So if you can count in your head while you're playing, you can do it that way. Or another good way is to tap your leg like this. You just kind of stomp a little bit. So while you're doing that, you start playing, and that keeps you good. How do I stay focused? It's okay, that's a hard question because I kind of don't stay focused, but when I start playing, my mind is like blank. I'm not thinking about anything. So when I'm playing, it's a whole different world. So staying in focus isn't something that I do a lot. So the real difference between using a pick, also known as a plectrum, and using your fingers is basically when you use a pick, there's different ways you can use it. So doing this is much harder than doing this. Basically, when you use a pick, you can really only do like one string at a time if you're picking, but if you use your hand, you can get at least five strings at the same time, making it more versatile to do. But if you're strumming, it's very important to know how to really use your hand to strum because if you don't, you're gonna hurt yourself. Very much so. Okay, some common mistakes that beginners make or many guitarists make is a lot of them don't think about thumb placement. It's very important to know where your thumb goes so that you can reach stuff. So there's like the upper position, the middle position, and then the lower position. Basically, the upper kind of like lets you do stuff on the lower strings. The middle does more of the middle and a little bit of the high, and then the lower position just lets you do everything that is up here. Some other common mistakes that I see a lot of people make is with their wrist. Their wrist doesn't go like this. They don't have that bend in their wrist, so they kind of like keep it straight and try to do things, which is not how you're supposed to do things. You want your wrist to be really bent and around the neck of the guitar, because then you can do lots of more things. Another common mistake that a lot of people make is when playing chords. The most often is the C chord, which kind of looks like this. Basically, what most people get wrong is the way they put their fingers on the strings, right? So when you want to do something over here with your left hand, you really want to do it like in the middle of your fingertips. So it's like really just like straight on into it. So you want your first knuckle here, like as straight onto the fretboard, is what we call it, as on as you can possibly be. When you press down on the strings, you want to press down hard, but not too hard, right? So there's a difference between like going like this and going like this. There's a subtlety to it, right? So you want to feel that you press down on the string, but not like you're hurting yourself, because if you do it too hard, you will hurt yourself. So just do it enough to where you can feel that it's pressed down. You will feel it. It's not something that's that hard. And some advice for someone that's just starting is just stick with it, because I know, like, when I'm playing, sometimes, like, when I'm learning something new, I really want to quit. Like, that's happened to me a couple of times before. Like, I almost just, like, threw this at a wall and just gave up. But I stuck with it, and now I'm happier because of it. It's something that you really have to love doing, because if you don't, you're gonna hate your life. And if you ever, like, get discouraged about, like, how other people play better than you or anything like that, you can just think about how you can just practice more, and then you'll get as good as them, because practice is amazing. Obviously, I'm gonna play a song that I made up a long time ago.